Most of my videos are inspired by clients I've helped in the past. When I assisted a couple relocating to Northern Virginia because of the husband's new position at the Pentagon, I noticed that they were vaguely familiar with the area, but really didn't know where they wanted to live. Initially, they were pretty open to any areas throughout Fairfax County and Arlington. Over time, it became clear that the commute time was most important to them. If you've seen my previous video on things you need to know before PCSing to the Pentagon, you know that traffic in the DC metro area can be, well, let's be honest, it can be brutal. Once we confirmed that the proximity to the Pentagon was the top priority for them, next on the list was finding a top-rated high school for their son. These two pieces of information allowed us to narrow down the search considerably. Ultimately, they decided to increase their housing budget significantly in order to live in Arlington, which accomplishes both of those goals. If you're like my past client and you're getting ready to PCS to the Pentagon, you may be balancing the same objectives. In this video, I'm going to go over some of your best options, taking into consideration your BAH. Whether you're looking to buy a home as soon as you get here or rent to learn the market, I'll share with you the average rental rate and sales price for some of the top locations in Northern Virginia. Be sure to watch until the end to learn about the one location in Northern Virginia that has the number 2, 3, and 4 high schools in the state. You don't want to miss it. Let's start the show. Hi, my name is Abraham Walker, your favorite Northern Virginia YouTube real estate agent. On this channel, I do the research so you don't have to. If you've been ordered to PCS to the Pentagon, use the link in the description to fill out your perfect home questionnaire. We will meet online and you can ask me anything you want to know about moving to Northern Virginia. Be sure to check out the PCSing to the Pentagon playlist for more videos like this one. Click the link right above me and there will also be a link in the description. Enough about me. What are the best areas to move when stationed at the Pentagon? Location. The first thing I want to talk about is narrowing down your home search. The Pentagon is located in Arlington, which is one of the most expensive parts of the Northern Virginia area. For this reason, many people also consider moving to Fairfax County and the city of Alexandria, both of which border Arlington. There are three things most people consider when moving to Northern Virginia: home price, home size, and commute. I've heard from buyers PCSing here that you should expect to compromise on at least one of those factors. So before you get started, you should number these in order of importance. If staying within a specific budget is most important to you, you may have to compromise on the type of home you choose. Let's say you'll get a townhouse over a single family home, or you may have to deal with a longer commute. The same goes for if the commute time is most important. If you want a short commute, you may have to consider either increasing your budget or looking at smaller property. The good thing is there are homes available throughout Northern Virginia that will allow you to stay within your BAH allowance. In other locations, you may be used to your BAH covering utilities. However, that may not be the case here. In 2021, the BAH for an O4 with dependents is $3,384 a month, while it's only $2,520 for an E4 with dependent. Arlington. Arlington is first up on our list, and this should come as no surprise to you. As I mentioned at the top of this video, the Pentagon is located in Arlington. And according to several outlets, it's one of the top areas to live in the entire country. Check out my video on the reason why Arlington was voted the best city to live in the country. Click the link right above me, and there will also be a link in the description. Arlington's proximity to Washington, D.C. is one of the main reasons why Arlington's cost of living is more than 150% of the national average. When it comes to housing, the average sales price of a two-bedroom condo was $537,000 in 2020. In comparison, the rent for the same size unit would be just over $2,500. A three-bedroom townhouse in Arlington rents for about $3,500 and sells for $900,000 on average. Finally, suppose you're interested in a larger home and possibly a larger outdoor area like a fenced backyard. In that case, you can expect to spend a little over $1.2 million on average and just under under $3,800 a month to rent the same sized home. Arlington has a highly rated school system according to niche.com. Its school system is number 2 in the state. The public schools in Arlington have been ranked the number 1 and 2 public school district in Virginia for a few years now. The attendance rates, test scores, and graduation rates are all high in Arlington. It's also home to the number 1 elementary school in the Commonwealth. Arlington Traditional Elementary School is a public magnet school and has consistently had A+ rating. To see what people say about living in Arlington versus Fairfax County, click on the link right above me to see my versus video. I compare Arlington to Fairfax County, and there will also be a link in the description. Fairfax County. Let's move on to Fairfax County. Fairfax County is located northwest of Arlington. It's the third largest county in America and offers a lot of variety in housing options. Regardless of your budget, you should be able to find a home in one of the many parts of Fairfax County. Here's where those commute times and types of home choices really come into play. Springfield, Virginia. The first area in Fairfax County we'll cover is Springfield. It's located about 10 miles from the Pentagon. Because of its proximity to DC, Fort Belvoir, and the Pentagon, you will find this neighborhood attracts a large number of military residents. Springfield has a strong military support network and even offers an express bus to the Pentagon to accommodate its residents' daily commute. A 3+ bedroom single family home in Springfield had an average sales price of $631,000, while the rent for the same type of home averaged around $2,900. Townhouses in Springfield rent for an average of $2,400 for a 3-bedroom, and the average sales price is $492,000. Springfield has many subdivisions, and each neighborhood offers its own amenity. Be sure to inquire about the HOA, how much the fees are, and what amenities are available. Springfield is known for being a community with streets lined with well-maintained lawns, rec centers, neighborhood pools, parks, shopping, and restaurant. When it comes to research and schools, the schools in West Springfield tend to rank slightly higher than other parts of Springfield. Specifically, West Springfield High is ranked as the number 7 high school in the entire state of Virginia. There are also some highly rated grammar schools in West Springfield, making it popular among families with kids at all grade levels. Since there are several elementary schools in the area, make sure you verify the school assignment on the Fairfax County Public School website. Use the address of the property you're interested in purchasing to verify what public school pyramid is linked to that property. If you made it this far, type PCS in the comment section to let me know you're still with me. While you're in the comment section, tell me what factors you consider when looking for a home near your new duty station. One more thing before we continue with the rest of the video. Since you've made it this far, it's safe to assume one of two things. One, you're either stationed here or will be in the near future. Two, you're my competition taking note. I made this video to answer as many questions as possible about the different areas you might consider while stationed at the Pentagon. The information in this video should make your move a little less stressful. If you plan to move soon, don't be shy. Reach out to me so I can assist you in finding your next home. The best way to reach out to me is through the link in the description to complete your perfect home questionnaire. After you complete the short survey, we'll meet virtually and you can ask me anything you want about Northern Virginia. Now back to our show. Burke. Next up, we have Burke, which is just a little further away, about 15 miles from the Pentagon. Like most of Northern Virginia, you can find many housing options, ranging from apartments to condos and townhouses to detached single-family homes. Compared to the other areas on today's list, Burke has more of a rural or small-town feel. At the same time, there are creature comforts like supermarkets and dining. It's less than what's available in other areas, but still only a short distance away. I'd say you can get most of your grocery shopping and basic needs taken care of within a 4-mile radius. In Burke, you're looking at an average sales price of $689,000 for a single-family detached home and $3,000 a month should you decide to rent. 3-bedroom townhouses in Burke rent for about $2,260 a month, and the average sales price is $456,000. In Burke, 2-bedroom condos go for about $285,000 on average and rent for $1,900 a month. There are a couple different subdivisions in Burke, but most of them belong to a larger homeowners association called Burke Center. Burke Center is made up of five different neighborhoods with 65 clusters representing nearly 6,000 homes. Amenities include five large swimming pools, seven tennis courts, and over 30 miles of walking trails. Burke is home to one of Fairfax County's top rated high schools, Lake Braddock Secondary. Now, Burke is a pretty big area, so not all Burke homes are zoned for Lake Braddock. However, another school that some homes in the area are zoned for is Robinson Secondary, located in nearby Fairfax. According to US News, Robinson and Lake Braddock Secondary schools are rated 11 and 12 respectively. Considering the top rated schools and overall lower prices, I think you can see why some folks opt to live a little further away from the base. Kingstowne. Another popular landing spot for military residents is Kingstowne. I live in Kingstowne, have for the last 8 years, and my family and I love it. Kingstowne is the second largest planned community in Fairfax County. It is in the Fairfax County part of Alexandria, not to be confused with the city of Alexandria. We'll discuss more about the city of Alexandria later in this video. Kingstowne is located about 12 miles from the Pentagon. Many people like Kingstowne because the commute isn't too bad and the homes are newer than some other areas in Fairfax County. Most homes in Kingstowne were built in the mid to late 90s. Compared to some of the other places on our list today, there are substantially more townhouses and fewer single-family homes. Now, a three-bedroom townhouse in Kingstowne is going to run you about $560,000 on average if you're planning to buy, and around $2,700 a month to rent. The average sales price of a single-family in Kingstowne is about $749,000 and rents for $3,500 on average. Kingstowne is also home to a handful of condominium developments with two-bedroom units costing around $360,000 and rentals averaging $1,950 a month. Additionally, there are a couple of other smaller subdivisions that border Kingstowne, making up the greater Kingstowne area. That includes Island Creek, Amberley, Hayfield Farm, Hayfield View, and Winter Park. What I like most about Kingstowne is the proximity to Creature Comforts. There are several supermarkets, a movie theater, and lots of shopping. The schools are rated pretty well, but aren't at the top of the charts like schools in other areas. For example, McLean, which is next up on our list. McLean. McLean is located just 10 miles from the Pentagon. It's going to be as close as you can get to Arlington while living in Fairfax County. Locals pronounce the word McLean. I know, that's just how it's pronounced. McLean is home to many military members, diplomats, members of Congress, and several high-ranking government officials. The prices in McLean are similar to those in Arlington, which is understandable considering its proximity. The U.S. Census Bureau named McLean as the third wealthiest county in the country in 2018. You could actually purchase a townhouse in some other areas mentioned for the same price as a condo in McLean. Two-bedroom condos would sell for just under $560,000, and the same condo would rent for about $2,330 a month. If you'd like to purchase a three-bedroom townhouse in McLean, you can expect to pay about $916,000 on average. The monthly rent on the same size townhouse would be approximately $3,400 a month. The average sales price of a three-bedroom plus single-family in McLean is about $1.5 million, and the average monthly rent is only $4,600. Living in McLean would put you in a position to enroll your children at some of the best public schools in Fairfax County. Addresses in McLean are assigned to McLean, Langley, and Marshall High School Pyramid. Those three high schools are rated number 2, 3, and 4 by U.S. News. The only school that is behind them is Thomas Jefferson High School for Science and Technology, the local area magnet school. As you can imagine, the elementary schools and middle schools that feed into these high schools are also very highly rated. There's also lots to do in McLean. It's home to the Tyson's Galleria, the Tyson's Corner Center, two huge shopping destinations. There are literally too many restaurants and entertainment options to name. Annandale. The last area I'll mention in Fairfax County is Annandale, which is located about 10 and a half miles from the Pentagon. Annandale is a good option if you are looking for a single family home, but don't necessarily want to compromise your budget or commute time. You can expect to pay around $720,000 for a single family home if you plan to buy, and $3,000 a month if you were to rent. You can rent a three-bedroom townhouse for about $2,400. That same three-bedroom townhouse would cost you about $487,000. So we see townhouses in Annandale are actually less expensive than all other areas I've mentioned. You would pay a little more to buy a single family, but less in Annandale to rent a single family. When it comes to schools, you're still in Fairfax County, which overall has pretty highly rated schools. City of Alexandria. Last on our list today is the City of Alexandria. Earlier I mentioned Kingstowne, which is on the Fairfax County side of Alexandria. This is the City of Alexandria, which is its own independent city. It borders Arlington, and because it's so close, that can sometimes be deceiving to those that are unfamiliar with the area. One common complaint I've heard from people that relocate here without doing proper research is that they believe because they were in Alexandria, within 5 miles to the Pentagon, they'd be able to get to and from work only in a few minutes. They're usually surprised to learn that they would have had a shorter commute had they moved to Springfield. Like I said before, traffic is hectic. So living here, you'll rely heavily on your GPS system's estimations and less on distance. Once you've been living here for a while, you'll see why locals say that miles don't equal minutes. Speaking of locals, I did a survey both my past clients and on social media about what it means to live in this area. Like, what would you like to have known before you moved here? To see that video, click here right above me or check the link in the description. Like the rest of the places I've mentioned today, you can find a wide range of housing options. It will likely cost less than Arlington and McLean, but more than other areas I mentioned in Fairfax County. On average, a three-bedroom townhouse would rent for $3,300, while it'll cost you about $825,000 to buy. You're looking at spending about $1.1 million for three or more bedroom single-family home and $3,500 a month to rent the same sized home. I'm a huge fan of Alexandria, the City of Alexandria, especially Old Town Alexandria, which is a busy historic district with lots of older architecture and cobblestone streets. It kind of reminds me of the French Quarter in my hometown of New Orleans. Whether you choose to move to Old Town or not, you'll hear about King Street. King Street has blocks and blocks of specialty shops and restaurants. On Saturday mornings, you can check out the oldest farmers market in the country. So you can see what you have to look forward to with the farmers market. I actually did a video with my wife walking through the farmers market on a Saturday morning. Click here to see that video. I'll also post the link in the description. The City of Alexandria isn't huge, and neither is their public school system. There's only one high school in the city. It isn't rated particularly well. It has a B rating on niche, but only 2 out of 10 on grade schools. US News does not include it as a top high school in the state. You shouldn't be surprised if you move to the City of Alexandria and a lot of your neighbors have their kids enrolled in private schools. It's just a thing. So those are my top suggestions on where to move when stationed at the Pentagon. I'd love to hear what you think. Have you been stationed at the Pentagon before? If so, where did you live? Was it mentioned in today's video? If you have questions about finding a home in Northern Virginia near the Pentagon or anywhere else, start the relocation process by clicking the link in the description to fill out your perfect home questionnaire. Once it's complete, we'll schedule a Zoom session to talk about your home search. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you on the next video. Peace.